In this episode, I'm going to show you how to make a video wall in Motion. I'm Mark Spencer from RippleTraining.com. Welcome to Motion Magic, where you'll learn visual effects and motion graphics in under 5 minutes.
The key to making a video wall in Motion is to have all of the clips in the video wall be contained in a single movie. And that's why I'm actually starting here in Final Cut Pro. So we can see I have some selects. I have 16 clips selected. These clips, if I select each one and look over in the inspector at their size and frame rate, you'll notice as I click through them by pressing the down arrow that we have multiple resolutions and multiple frame rates. I want each of these to have the same duration, the same frame size, and the same frame rate. So what I've done is I've created a project that is 1280 by 720 and 24p. It's basically the lowest common denominator of size and frame rate of each of the clips I want to use. I'm going to select all these clips by pressing Command A and then press E to append them to the timeline. I'll press Shift Z to fit them onto the timeline. And you notice right away, these are all different durations. I made sure they were all at least 5 seconds because I'm going to make a video wall that lasts for 5 seconds. So I'll select them all. I'll press Control D and I'll enter 5 period for 5 seconds. I'll press Shift Z. And now we have 16 clips, each of which are 5 seconds long. So now I want to export this as a single QuickTime movie. And here's what it looks like right here. A single QuickTime movie, Command-I to get info, 1280 by 720, 24 frames per second. And if I scrub through it, we can see we have each of our 16 clips all in a single movie with the same settings. Let's go over to Motion. And in Motion, I want to create a project that matches this clip. I'll choose Create Project from File. I'll then select this clip, choose Import as Project, and then if we select the project and go to the inspector and look at the properties for this project, we can see it's 1280 by 720, 24 frames per second. And the duration of this project matches the duration of our 16 clips that are each 5 seconds long, which comes out to 1 minute 20 seconds. Now we'll shorten this later, but project duration lasts for the size of the clip. So I'll select the clip, and I want to use a replicator to make the video wall. So I'll click the replicator button. And then in the replicator inspector, I'm going to make a couple of changes. I have 16 clips, so I'm going to create a 4x4 video wall. I'm going to go down to the scale and set the scale to about 24% so that they're smaller. And then in the canvas, I can drag out on this control. Looks like I need to make them a little smaller, so there's some gap between them, and bring these together. And there I've got the beginnings of my video wall. Let's make them a little bit smaller. Press Shift Z to fit everything to the window. Make sure we're looking at the entire canvas, and there we go. That looks great. However, we have every video playing at exactly the same time, which is not what we want. The key here to have each clip in the video wall show a separate clip is in this source frame offset. Now remember, we had 5 seconds per clip, and 5 seconds in a 24 frame per second project is 5 times 24, or 120. So I'll set the source frame offset to 120, and that allows us to have each cell be a different clip. Now we still see some repeating going on, and that's a function of the origin up here in the replicator inspector. So for the origin, I'm going to choose to start from the upper left, and then for the build style that appears, I'm going to choose by row. And now we have each individual clip appearing in each one of these cells of the replicator. So now's a good time to change our overall project duration to 5 seconds. Show project duration. I'll double click, type 5 period. And now we have a 5 second project, and each cell of the replicator shows just that 120 frames for that particular portion of our overall QuickTime movie. If you don't like the order of these clips, you can choose to shuffle the order by clicking the shuffle order checkbox, and then you can click the generate button for replicate seed to change where each clip ends up in the grid. From here, you can do things like use a sequence replicator behavior to animate each cell of the replicator, add a camera so that you can move around 3D space, and add reflections. So that, for example, you could end up with something that looks like this. Click the subscribe button below, and please leave us your comments and suggestions for future topics. Go to RippleTraining.com for fast professional training on Final Cut Pro 10, Motion, and DaVinci Resolve from industry professionals.